Hi, everybody, and welcome to another exciting hour of Mid-South Wrestling. I'm Jim Rouse, and along with Joel Watts, we'll be calling the action, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a tremendous hour in store for you. You're going to see Ted DiBiase and Dr. Dest Williams, the Mid-South Tag Champions, go against superstar Bill Dundee and impressive newcomer Wendell Cooley. You'll also see the combination of Dirty Dutch Mantel and Tom Pritchard in action. You'll see the Mid-South TV champion, the Snowman. He's here today. Plus, Rick Housebrand and Brad Armstrong in tag team competition. You'll see Private Terry Daniels against the man, the number one man in wrestling right now, according to many insiders. That's the NWA World's Champion, Ric Flair. Plus, you will see Terry Taylor defend the North American title in our television main event against the undefeated Nightmare. And ladies and gentlemen, also Kamala's here. Joel, should be an exciting hour. We had a great hour last week.
Oh, no question about it. But I think one of the highlights of last week was Skandar Akbar came out and introduced a new member of Devastation Incorporated, an awesome individual, The Brute. During that time, Hacksaw Duggan came onto the scene. Well, I think words can't describe it. Here's what happened.
Wait a minute.
Oh! Hacksaw Duggan! Hacksaw Duggan chasing Akbar!
He's going after Akbar. He's got him by the shirt. He's got Akbar. The Brute ran that chair, but Duggan kicked him in the midsection.
Hacksaw Duggan's walking tall! Through the chair at Akbar. We've got mayhem on Mid-South Wrestling.
Oh, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. What an exit.
He's back and the people are standing. The big Hacksaw is walking tall. The dressing room's empty. The guys are glad to see him back. This place is pandemonium.
Oh, yeah.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan is back.
This crowd was electrified, ladies and gentlemen, last week when Hacksaw Duggan returned. This place went to a frenzy, Joe.
Oh, it was great. Hacksaw Jim Duggan returning after that eye injury. The doctors told him not to do it. His family told him not to do it. But he went out and did it anyway and stood up for what he thought was right. I think it's great.
I sure do, too. And I'm sure the fans are so elated as we are. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Skandar Akbar and Kamala are into the ring. Let's go now to ring announcer Boyd Pierce.
This event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 408 pounds, Manager General Skandar Akbar presents Kamala, the Ugandan warrior. And across the ring, in the blue corner, at 221 pounds, from the state of Virginia, Mike Somani. One fall, 10-minute time limit. Your referee, Randy Anderson.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you hear it. The ring introductions. Skandar Akbar taking his good old time, and Akbar now coming over. What's he doing?
I've got something to say to you, Duggan. I know that you're back. The biggest mistake you made is when you came against doctor's orders and you returned to Mid-South. Now I'm going to remind you of something, Duggan. All it takes is one little accident, and that good eye of yours, you'll be an invalid. And as for Cowboy Bill Watts, I don't think Mid-South has facilities to handle two invalids. So now I make myself clear. And if I don't, you'd better heed exactly what I'm telling you, Duggan, because you'll be pushing pencils on the street corner along with Cowboy Watts, and Watts, you know exactly how I feel.
Well, that impromptu press conference from General Skandar Akbar, he made some very pointed comments to Hacksaw Duggan and to Cowboy Bill Watts as well. He's got Kamala in there, and Kamala, 400 pounds plus of unleashed fury.
I think it's easy to see that Hacksaw Jim Duggan's energies will be directed towards getting revenge against Kamala and Skandar Akbar. And I certainly hope he's successful in his venture, but this is the man that he's got to contend with in doing so, Kamala. And I tell you, there's probably not a more awesome force when you're talking just size, brute power, combined with tremendous agility than Kamala.
Over 400 pounds coming down on Mike Ciamini. Akbar made a statement and Kamala made a very physical one. And we'll be back with a North American title match right after this word for Mid-South sponsors.
This event, one fall or television time remaining for the North American Heavyweight Championship. In the red corner, from parts unknown, the challenger, the Nightmare. And the challenger is seconded by General Eddie Gilbert. Across the ring, 231 pounds in the blue corner, from Vero Beach, Florida, the North American Heavyweight Champion, Terry Taylor. Your referee for this title match, Carl Fergie. One fall or television time remaining.
Gentlemen, it's no secret to anybody throughout the wrestling world that Terry Taylor, being a North American heavyweight champion, is the number one contender for the world's heavyweight championship. As a matter of fact, I'm even a little jealous of that big silver belt you're wearing, brother. But we're going to take care of that tonight. I got $10,000, and you know what comes out of my mouth is as good as gold, brother. I've always had life the way I wanted it. What I couldn't go out and get, I bought and paid for, brother. So tonight, $10,000 to you, $10,000 to your man. Bring me home that North American Heavyweight Championship and leave this kid on his backside where he belongs. $10,000.
Well, there you hear that announcement. Ric Flair, the world's champion, has just put an impromptu bounty, or a big, big bonus, and even more incentive than was already there to begin with in the corner of the Nightmare and General Eddie Gilbert. There's the bell. The North American title contest is underway. Terry Taylor, the champion, being challenged by the undefeated Nightmare.
The Nightmare is certainly an awesome force. Terry Taylor has reckoned with some of the best of them and has come out on top. I think Ric Flair has stated publicly that he doesn't want to ever have to defend his World Heavyweight title against Terry Taylor again. And if Terry Taylor were to lose that North American title, he would not be in top contention for the world title anymore. I think that is the main reason behind Ric Flair putting the bounty on this match. Terry trying to body slam the Nightmare, but the Nightmare, very, very powerful, managed to block it. Nightmare goes for the arm whip. Terry Taylor reverses and catches him in the body slam. Terry Taylor has a strategy. He goes at it at all costs, and he...
Well, you can assure yourself of one thing, ladies and gentlemen, that Taylor has got a great game plan. I think that's one of the things that concerns Flair. Taylor has a game plan every time he gets in the squared circle. And as you said, though, Joel, so very well put, if Taylor loses the North American title, then Flair will not be forced to have to put the NWA World's title on the line against him.
Taylor managed to turn that situation to his advantage. Taylor's a great counter wrestler. in the ring, he thinks so coolly and stoically. He doesn't expend a lot of nervous energy. He's a quick thinker and a quick counter wrestler. Taylor with the kick to the midsection manages to nail the Nightmare into that turnbuckle, and now he's using those ropes to his advantage, much to Flair's chagrin on the outside of the ring. Taylor with that arm whip. You can hear the fans solidly behind Terry. Taylor with a headbutt to the midsection. He's got the Nightmare where he wants him right now, but the Nightmare is so powerful and has such a high threshold of pain. Taylor has really, really got to kick it in gear against this awesome monster. Another right by the Nightmare. He turns the tables quickly on Terry. It looks to me, Jim, that this is going to be a close match.
It sure does. Of course, the Nightmare has not been defeated Mid-South as of yet. Terry Taylor trying to keep his winning streak alive as well.
General Eddie Gilbert, of course, fled home, I'm sure, what was a very, very good scouting report on Terry Taylor after his match with him last week on Mid-South Wrestling.
Terry catches Nightmare with a right, and he's got him staggered. Another right. And Nightmare shaking it around. Terry really hitting him hard, but he can't take the big man off his feet. Yeah, a hard shoulder smash knocks the Nightmare down to the mat.
Ooh. Oh. What a clothesline. He came from third base on that one. What a clothesline. Taylor near the rope area, but he did elevate the Nightmare after that count of two, and Taylor is in trouble. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be an exciting hour. We've got a lot of some more great action for you. Tag team champions are here. The TV champion, the Snowman's here. And don't forget, next week, Rock and Roll Express returns. Superstar Bill Dundee, the Dirty White Boys, and Cowboy Bill Watts in the ring next week right here on Mid-South Wrestling.
The Nightmare there with the lateral press just about had Terry Taylor for the two count. The Nightmare really applying the pressure to the head and neck area of Terry Taylor. He's got his weight up above Terry Taylor, holding him down, and that is exactly where Terry Taylor does not want to be. He doesn't need to be underneath the weight of the Nightmare. He needs to keep his distance from that man, stay away from that brute force of the Nightmare.
You know, one of Terry Taylor's fortes is the ability to change gears and control the tempo. At this point in time in this contest, the Nightmare is controlling the tempo. He has slowed it down to his pace. And perhaps it's up to his advantage at this point in time, as we're seeing Terry Taylor try to extricate himself.
We've seen Terry Taylor come back from some insurmountable odds. We saw him defeat Nikolai Volkov on Mid-South Wrestling once with that same maneuver that he just used on the Nightmare. The Nightmare kicks out of it. The Nightmare is really, really awesome.
The Nightmare just threw Taylor right across that top cable. Flair is ecstatic on the outside. General Eddie Gilbert has a very confident look on his face as well. Remember, Flair put $10,000 on the line as an inducement for the Nightmare to take this title, the North American title, away from Terry Taylor.
Nightmare using those ropes to his advantage, gaining momentum on Terry Taylor. The young champion is really, really going to have to get on the aggression. Oh, we just about saw a new North American champion there. The Nightmare caught him.
Well, Blair wanted the referee to count faster. Fergie's count was just fine. Taylor did. He got out of it.
Well, Fergie's count is always very deliberate. I've never seen him deliberately speed up or slow down a count in any instance. A fine, fine referee. The Nightmare really catching him hard. But Taylor comes back with a right of his own. That could be the break he needed. He managed to stagger the Nightmare, and now he's got him in the ropes again. Taylor using those ropes to his advantage. He gets the arm whip. Nightmare goes into the turnbuckle hard. Managed to hold on. Terry Taylor's down now.
And Joe, it's got to be so distracting, so mind-boggling. Ric Flair on the outside, the man that has the gold. Eddie Gilbert on the other side of the ring, leading the cheers for his man. And Terry Taylor fighting back, and these people, this packed Irish McNeil Boys Club, are solidly behind the champion.
As long as Terry Taylor can avoid any interference from these two men, I think he's got a chance. Terry Taylor's got a chance about it against any wrestler. He's proven it time and time again. He is a world-class competitor. But the Nightmare is really, really surprising. He is really making a name for himself.
Taylor catches it. Taylor caught it with a drop kick. See, he got that distance away from him. He got out from underneath the weight of the Nightmare, and there he's in that headlock again. Nice move by Terry again. Good strategy. Catches him that rear suplex. And Taylor now a little bit winded. He suffered a lot of punishment. Lateral press. One, two.
That Nightmare's awesome strength. He powered out.
Oh, he kicked him right in the face. He ran across the ring and kicked him right in the face.
The Nightmare's on the second rope now. Taylor catches him in the midsection. What a match. Terry Taylor catches him in the midsection and manages to pull it out once again. He's got some room. He catches him with a right. Another right. Nightmare's on the ropes, but the Nightmare, what a tough, tough individual. He is really, really rugged. Such a high threshold of pain. Such a vicious man. A hard kick to the midsection. The fans solidly behind Terry still. I think he needs the encouragement at this point because this big man has been relentless in his attack. The Nightmare's got him over in the ropes. You're not going to catch a fall on Terry Taylor over there. He's going to try to add punishment at this point, it looks like. Terry Taylor, a fantastic fighting heart. But he really needs to kick it in gear. The Nightmare going up to the second rope again. The Nightmare's going to the second rope again, and Terry Taylor is practically unconscious. Terry Taylor gets his knees up, catches the Nightmare in the midsection. Nature Boy Ric Flair is going nuts on the outside of the ring. He doesn't want to have to face Terry Taylor again. Terry kicking him hard in the midsection, a hard right. A hard right, they're squaring off. They're squaring off toe to toe. Terry's got the distance on him. Taylor gets the arm whip. Beautiful, he elevated him. The North American champion's on a roll. He's got the Nightmare now. He's getting the momentum. Come on, Taylor. Come on, Terry.
Terry Taylor's on fire. The momentum, the pace has quickened. Taylor on the offensive. This is what he wanted.
Nightmare reverses the arm whip. Taylor ducks the clothesline in the forearm. He got the forearm on it. This arm. Cover him. Terry Taylor doesn't go for the lateral press. He goes for the figure four. What strategy. He goes for the figure four. He's got it locked in.
Taylor's got it locked. Flair's on the apron. And look at Gilbert.
Flair's on the apron. Gilbert is pulling. Gilbert's pulling the Nightmare. The Nightmare's into the ropes. He's got to break the hold now. But if Eddie Gilbert hadn't have pulled him over, we would have seen, I think, the end of the Nightmare. The Nightmare up. His knees are hurting him. Taylor's got him set for it again. Come on, Terry. The Nightmare kicks him off, but Ric Flair trips Terry Taylor from the outside. Ric Flair trips Terry Taylor from the outside. The Nightmare back up on his feet. Carl Fergie admonishing Ric Flair for his actions outside of the ring. That's just the pile driver. Nightmare went for the pile driver. Terry Taylor reversed it. Taylor catches Gilbert and slingshots him into the ring. A hard right. Gilbert retreats. But Ric Flair handed something to the Nightmare outside of the ring. The Nightmare catches
Oh, no!
Goodness! Ric Flair handed something to Terry. To the Nightmare, it looked as if he put it into his mask.
Flair handed something to the Nightmare. The Nightmare put it in his mask. He knocked Taylor cold. We've got a new North American champion. Hey. We've got a new champion. I can't believe this. We'll be back with more Mid-South Wrestling after this word for the Mid-South Network. I can't believe it.
This is your first standby bout. One fall or television time remaining. In the red corner at 242 pounds from Charlotte, North Carolina, NWA World Heavyweight Champion, Rick Flair. And across the ring, in the blue corner, at 223 pounds from the Cobra Corps of Amarillo, Texas, Private Terry Daniels. One fall or television time remaining. Your referee, Randy Anderson.
Wait a minute. I just got something to say to the world's champion. You know, I've got my hands full with Skandar Akbar and everything that's going on. But, you know, after what I just saw, I have to say what I think. And I'm pretty disappointed because I'm sure there's a lot of kids that look up to you. A lot of people look up to you because you're the world champion. And you come out here and you pull some crap like that, let me tell you something. Hacksaw Duggan doesn't appreciate it, and the people of Mid-South don't appreciate it.
Would you like me to shed a tear for all the little kids in the world that are growing up to be like Ric Flair, but never will be? You want me to shed a tear because the Mid-South has a new champion? Forget it. Taylor was a loser. He couldn't handle it. And let me know, I'm not through talking. First of all, when you have the audacity to walk in the ring that I own, operate, manipulate because I'm the world champion during one of my matches, then you pay close attention. Now you see, you're already here when the doctors tell you you're not supposed to be. Your mommy tells you you're not supposed to be. All your friends, all your friends tell you you're not supposed to be. And I want to make something very clear to you, Duggan. If you get in my face again, brother, you're going to have two bad eyes because you ain't nothing but a low-class Cajun redneck, brother.
Hey, Big Shot, I don't gotta take this.
Whoa! Hacksaw Duggan, he makes a statement in more. Whoa!
Oh, I do not blame him. Hacksaw Duggan stands up for what he believes in 100%.
He's got Flair up. There's Akbar Kamala. Akbar Kamala.
Akbar just annihilated Terry Daniels. Kamala in there firing away at Hacksaw Duggan. Duggan's in a bad way now against the world's heavyweight champion at 400-pound Kamala. This is mayhem, Jim.
It is.
This has gotten out of control. Ric Flair just single leg. Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Or Kamala was holding it. Kamala with those awesome chops. There goes Randy Anderson. Ric Flair just threw him into the steel cables. Oh! Skandar Akbar and Ric Flair holding it.
They're trying to put Duggan away. He splashed him once. Come on in.
We got to get some help out here. We got to get some help out here. Kamala going to the top rope. Duggan down, helpless on the ground. Duggan's getting out. Duggan, get out. What's Duggan doing? Duggan's looking for a chair. Duggan's got a chair.
Duggan's got a chair, and they're leaving. Hacksaw Duggan got a chair. Flair, come on, Akbar. They're gone. Daggett's walking tall, but Akbar come on and try to get him once again. Hacksaw Daggett. He's walking tall, and we'll be back with more Mid-South Wrestling right after this.
This is your second standby bout, a tag team match, one fall or television time remaining. In the red corner at a combined weight of 460 pounds, from Alabama, Vern Deaton. And his partner from parts unknown, the Bruiser. The popular duo of Brickhouse Brown and Brad Armstrong. Arl Fergie, your referee.
Tag team action here on Mid-South. This crowd is still buzzing. As Hacksaw Duggan walked tall, it looked bad for a second. I'll tell you, Akbar, Kamala, and another tremendous attack on Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Ric Flair, the world's champion, very instrumental in that situation. Thank goodness that Hacksaw Duggan did extricate himself from that predicament, and when he got that chair, brother, they cleared the ring.
Now the ring got scarce once that chair came into the ring. Hacksaw Duggan, of course, doesn't use that kind of stuff unless he absolutely has to, but when he does, brother, he is feared. And there goes Brickhouse Brown throwing that Bruiser out of the corner, hard down to the mat. Brickhouse Brad Armstrong, as Boyd Pierce said, a very popular duo. They complement each other's styles very well, both of them. Very strong, very agile. Good basic wrestlers. They know how to use all parts of their body as a weapon.
And they're extremely quick, and they have an unbelievable change of pace. Brad Armstrong and the Bruiser in there at this point in time. And Armstrong has much the better of it. In comes Vern Deaton, and how do you do, Vern? This is Brad Armstrong.
Brad's level of intensity in his matches has really increased since he's been in the Mid-South area, I think. He's learned quite a bit, of course.
Ooh.
You gotta remember, whoa, Brickhouse Brown. Brickhouse Brown with that headbutt.
Brickhouse Brown with a thunderous flying headbutt. And he says it. If we're going to dance to the ring, and if we win, we're going to dance for the fans.
They plan on doing a lot of dancing.
That's right. That's what he says, and ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with the Mid-South Television Champion, the Snowman, right after this from the Mid-South Network.
This is your third standby bout, one fall or television time remaining. In the red corner from North Carolina, Jim Jeffers. And in the blue corner at 254 pounds, the Mid-South Television Champion from Memphis, the Snowman, referee Randy Anderson.
The Snowman, the Mid-South Television Champion, about to go at it with 260 pounds. Jim Jeffers, as Randy Anderson, the third man in the ring, calls for the bell. snowman, has electrified crowds wherever he has been. He has made one of the most significant and the biggest impacts of any athlete in professional wrestling.
Oh, that snowman, when he catches you with that 500-pound bench press strength, those right crosses, well, he can tear your head off. He evokes pity for the people that are against him. Look at that clothesline. Jim Jeffers hadn't even got out of the starting blocks against this awesome machine.
Oh! He planted him! Yes, sir! The snowman, he does not work by the hour. He said that before. He made short work, and I mean short work, of Jim Jeffers, ladies and gentlemen. The snowman, a force to be reckoned with anywhere in the country. And we'll be back with a great tag team encounter right after this from Mid-South.
This is your fourth standby bout, one fall or television time remaining. The Texas team in the red corner, from All Trough, Texas, Dirty Dutch Mantell. And from Houston, Texas, Tom Richard. Across the ring, Buffalo, New York, Mark Reagan. And his team partner, 236 pounds, from Tampa, Florida, Frank Lane.
Tag team action hero, Mid-South, ladies and gentlemen, Dirty Dutch Mantell and Tommy Pritchard, that Texas team that Boyd Pierce introduced. It's going to be Tommy Pritchard against Mark Reagan, and this pace will be quick.
I think Grizzly Smith should be commended for his choice of this tag team. I think it'll turn out to be a very good match. Frank Lane, of course, a newcomer to the Mid-South area. Mark Reagan, a terrific young athlete. Tommy Pritchard, also a great young wrestler. Seen a change of philosophy from Tommy Pritchard recently, but he's become a little bit more vicious, I've noticed, and a little bit, sometimes even though he's more vicious, he's become more methodical in some respects.
And very arrogant, I might add, Joel. Very arrogant.
Extremely. Now, Dirty Dutch Mantell in there, a tactician, a very vicious, aggressive wrestler. Tommy Pritchard and Dirty Dutch Mantell taking advantage of the quick tag tactic. Tommy Pritchard with that back wheel kick. Straight flush to the midsection. They're really trying to put Mark Reagan away in a hurry.
Ooh. Power of a body slam, then he really dropped the elbow on him. There's the tag. They've tagged in extremely well, Joel. They've worked great as a team thus far. Now, speaking of Pritchard and Daniels, of course, we haven't got to see Frank Lane as of yet.
Frank Lane's out there beckoning Reagan on to make the tag. Speaking of tag teams, we've got our Mid-South Tag Team Champions coming up in action next. Ted DiBiase and Dr. Death. Of course, this is one fall with the television time remaining.
Of course, they're going to be going against superstar Bill Dundee and Wendell Cooley. I think that's going to be a great matchup. And don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, next week, the legendary Cowboy Bill Watts right here in action next week.
The Rock and Roll Express will be back speaking more tag team action. Mark Reagan just caught Tommy Pritchard hard with the right cross, but he still hasn't accomplished the objective that he needs to right now, and that is to make that tag. Because Pritchard and Mantell have really, really mounted up a lot of punishment on Mark Reagan thus far. The tag is made. Dirty Dutch Mantell back in. Mark Reagan, of course, yet to see a tag.
Reagan's fighting away, but boy, they have really kept the pressure on him. Mantell and Pritchard have fought this match, perhaps the whole match practically, in their half of the ring, which is classic tag team strategy. They're double teaming a referee. Carl Fergie's got to get some order here.
Dutch Mantell there, I think he was trying to distract referee Carl Fergie.
Reagan's had it up. Mark Reagan really caught him hard with a couple of right crosses. Beautiful, beautiful.
Frank Lane in now.
Hard with the left, the arm whip, drop kick. Tommy Pritchard looking for a chance to get after him, but Lane with a double leg. Lane now with a knee drop to the head, but he's up against two men. Mantell and Pritchard both, all four men in the ring now. It's just an out-and-out melee. Dutch Mantell firing Lane off. Oh, Mantell really caught Lane with a hard clothesline, and Tommy Pritchard has kicked Mark Reagan and thrown him out of the ring. The MX! Dutch Mantell with the MX on Frank Lane.
And Mantell and Pritchard so aggressive. Wait a minute. Dutch Mantell's getting shoe baby. Oh,
Pritchard's
no.
Mark Reagan's coming back in. He's trying to stop him. But Pritchard with a double leg. He's out to make. Oh, he clobbered him with the end of that bull whip. He clobbered Reagan.
They set Frank Lane on fire with that bull whip. And now they're getting set to whip Mark Reagan.
Carl Fergie's trying to stop him. There ain't much he can do. Dutch Mantell's over there. He's setting up to whip him. Look at him go. He's got that whip. Oh, no. Wait a minute. It's a snowman. Whoa. The snowman tried to stop. The snowman got that whip away from Mantell. All right. All right.
The snowman's taking over on both men. He took the whip away from Mantell. The snowman, 255 pounds. He's all man. Ladies and gentlemen, we got to get some order back in this situation. We'll be back. We'll be right back with more Mid-South Wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're here with the snowman. You just saw what happened with Dirty Dutch Mantell. I know you're incensed over the situation.
Yeah, we saw it happen with Dirty Dutch Mantell and the old tactics that he'd be using. Let me tell you something. Dutch Mantell, don't nobody in the world play these kind of tactics no more. It ain't 19, it ain't no way 1827, 1828, 1957. Ain't nobody living back in the past. Ain't nobody going for this. Let me tell you something, boy. Ain't nobody picking cotton, chopping cotton no more nowhere. Let me tell you something. Don't you ever pull a stunt like that again. And let me tell you something, Dutch Mantell. Boy, you got one more time to ever let me see you do it. I know you're trying to do it. This shoe, baby. I'm thinking about keeping this shoe, baby. Let me tell you something, baby. Ain't nobody gonna ever hit a brother with no whip. Because let me tell you, it ain't slavery. It's 1985, sucker.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, those comments. What else can you add to that,
Joe? Evidently, his mama must have been raised, boy, because ain't nobody sitting on the back of the bus no more. You know, I know what the ghetto means. A lot of people know what the ghetto means. We work real hard, and you don't beat nobody in the ring with no whip, boy.
Exactly right. I wholeheartedly agree with those.
I do, too, ladies and gentlemen. Those comments, we echo them 100% from the Snowman. Let's go now to ring announcer Boyd Pierce.
This is your fifth standby match. One fall or television time remaining. In the red corner, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, Ted DiBiase and Dr. Death Steve Williams. And across the ring, their opponents, Wendell Cooley and superstar Bill Dundee.
Ladies and gentlemen, the crowd standing here. People, what an exciting hour we've had here on Mid-South Wrestling. I'll tell you, it's been unbelievable. Wait a minute. There's Jake Robertson and the Barbarian. Now, what's going on now? They're calling Boyd Pierce back into the ring.
It's got to do with you guys to just cool your heels, all right? What it's got to do with, Ted,
is that this business is about money. You happen to be the Mid-South Tag Team Champions. And all I'm doing, Ted, is telling you, since you're the champion, you got to take a challenge, and the challenge is coming from us. So why not? Now, I know these guys are great athletes, Teddy, but why don't you just put the titles up on the line and try us on for size?
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, Robertson. Who do you think you are to come slithering out here with this great big muscle head to back you up, demanding anything of the Mid-South Tag Team Champions?
You're a weasel.
Back off, musclehead. Let me tell you something. The bottom line is this, Jake Roberts. Hit the back of the line. The line forms at the rear. We waited 6 months to get these belts. Who do you think you are coming out here making any demands?
Teddy, you know me better than anybody else, and I've always told you, my man, I don't like long lines.
Hey! Whoa! Damn, it's like a pack of dogs out there. Even people you think are buddies, they're going at it fist to fire.
Well, this is not a match. There's not a match. Dundee and Wendell Kelly said, let them beat each other to death. We've got four brawlers, and they're getting it on in the ring. Brother, this is a Pier 6 brawl.
All four men going at it. Those Mid-South Tag Team titles mean a lot of things to a lot of people. All four of these men, they're just going wild. I can't believe it.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we got Dutch Mantel out here, too. They're all out here.
Let me tell that snowman one thing. He's an awful ignorant man, and he's talking about 1957, 1860. Well, let me tell you one thing, snowman. It's going to be a lot worse than that when we meet up again, buddy. Because nobody takes my whip from me, and nobody busts my mouth the way he did. I'm a man just like he's a man, but I'm a better man. I walk tall, and I'm a better man than Snowman will ever be. He's hit a lot of success here lately, baby. But Dutch Mantel, Snowman, I ain't through with you, and you're going to wish you were on the back of the bus before I'm through with you.
All right, that's quite enough from Dutch Mantel, ladies and gentlemen. This all heck is broken loose in the ring. Remember, next week, Rock and Roll Express will be back. Plus, Cowboy Bill Watts in action right here next week for Joel Watts and Boyd Pierce. I'm Jim Ross saying so long, everybody.